So what did our panel think of what Mrs. Turia was saying? I have to say, gosh, I like her, Matt MacCarten. Everything she speaks seems to be such common sense.
Yeah, well, she's saying the same thing she said before the Maori Party was formed, but now Pākehā, I think, eventually moved, is that what you've got now is the sort of states like sort of grandma, others saying the same things, you know, separate development, all the things. She hasn't backed away from anything she's ever stood
and suddenly
for,
the way she's talking about separate development doesn't seem to frighten the horses anymore.
Yes, exactly, because the thing is, most New Zealanders have got it, right? It's not working. For Māori. Māori are at the bottom of all the stats. And what the Māori Party's contribution has to be saying, we will argue to get resources to do it in another way that we think will work. And most Pākehā will go, well, that seems a reasonable thing. We know that half the prison are Māori. We know that all the stats are at the bottom. So this is worth a crack.
Well, we get it too, don't we, when she says we need to target families, not the individuals. I mean, that's a particularly Māori thing. What did you make of her?
Well, talking about bulk funding, you know, it worked extremely well in the education system, but, you know, the left and the unions there didn't like it.
Help yourself, Alasdair.
and it works well in the Navy, you know, the commanders of the ships, they're bulk funded. It's only when they break down in the Northern Hemisphere that they have to get a bit extra to tow home. But look, there's nothing wrong with the principle of bulk funding. And self-determination, not separate development. She did not talk about separate development. She talked about self-determination. And I think that that's the key, the difference. It's when you talk about separate development or apartheid sort of systems that people get angsty.
And I think in terms of this, we will have to wait and see when in the next few weeks. I think in June she was talking about perhaps that Mason Dury would come up with some suggestions about how, you know, fill out the flesh on how they would do that. And then I think the major question really we need to focus on, will it work, and accountability. You know, you've got to make sure that money, you can maintain
accountability. But there are many examples already where it's been working for some years, particularly in the health area. Can I just
Look at Waipara Trust, you know, it is a success story. And that's what they're talking about, saying, give us the resourcing instead of Wellington departments doing it, we'll make it work. I think the concerns I would have as a left, if it was a for-profit model, which it is clearly not. And I think that the way the Māori Party are doing it is they have to deliver to their constituents and be seen. Because in 3 years' time, or two and a half years' time, they're going to stand for the seats again. And Labour, of course, their competitor in the electorates, are going to say, show us what you've done.
Exactly,
and that's why
so
it's important.
But let's see, just go back to what Mrs. Turia was saying about this kind of a self-determining fund, this kind of devolution fund. Here's what she said.
This scheme, in fact, could be run off to Pacific communities, to ethnic minority communities, and to non-Māori communities should they choose. But this budget is for Māori.
So very diplomatic, you see, keeping it so wide, so unfrightening, so diplomatic. And that's one of the things really that impressed me about the whole interview, is what a master diplomat she was. I know that you're anxious to discuss whether the Maori Party made a mistake going with the National Party. But she said at one point, no, we're not going to rush things about entrenchment. We want a respectful relationship with our coalition partner. This is masterful.
Well, I think the problem isn't necessarily that they've gone with National, but if you look at the experience in New Zealand, every single small party so far that has gone into government has been basically hammered at the next election. So it's not specifically that they've gone with National, but rather just being a small party in a government, we tend to flog that small party at the next election.
But
it's even true for parties that are with this confidence and supply agreement.
But the Greens haven't been hammered.
They've never been in government. They've never been part of government.
Okay.
But I think something's changed, though, hasn't it? Something's changed this time. We've got used to how MMP works. It's part of that. This is a very smart crowd, the Maori Party. We know this.
They are, because they've actually led sort of movements outside of Parliament. All of those MPs, they know how to keep in contact with their base. The difference they have is National and the Māori Party are not electoral competitors. Where all the coalitions they have been. And so it is in National's interest to have the Maori Party look good and expand its base. Whereas if Maori had naturally gone on with a Labor government, they're competitors for the seats. And the difference about this coalition.
Dead right. Easier to go with the enemy than the electoral rival.
And also the attacks won't come from the right. What Tariana was saying today, if she'd been in a Labor coalition, sort of Alistair's mates, they would have been going berserk about separate development. And now he's got to swallow his dead rats and say,
with Matt that there's real incentive for National to make this work because basically National is not competitive in the Maori seats. If the Maori Party is successful, they're taking votes away from Labor, and that only helps National. Plus, in terms of the survival guide for small parties, Matt's absolutely right. That is one of the main points. The second main point, though, is you've got to make sure that your deal, that your voters aren't surprised by the deal, and it's not the wrong party in terms of
which was popularity. The big problem with Winston Peters and that first big deal with Bolger way back. Can I just change direction? Fiji. She was most interesting and again beautifully diplomatic on Fiji. Here's what Mrs. Turia said about the possibility of the Maori Party contributing to a resolution in Fiji.
I know that Dr. Sharples is very keen to look at how we might be able to use New Zealand leadership.
You were nodding during that. I mean, you like that.
Yes, I did. And I think she made a point that a lot of New Zealanders don't understand. Whereas in the past, all of the coups have been about giving Fijians a preferential position in the Fiji society, this coup was about making sure that all Fiji citizens, Indian and Fijians, had equal rights. Now, that hasn't come through very strongly in the media. Now, Bainio Rama has certainly pushed out this election thing.
They got equal rights. They all have no rights anymore.
Well, but the coup was about achieving a society without corruption
and
without favouritism.
A good military coup.
Coup is a good coup.
If she said this 5 years...
Five
years ago, if she had said this, everyone would have said that she was supporting the military coup, we're not having anything to do with them, et cetera, et cetera. That's what they've all been up to now. But it's interesting, she changes the language.
Yep.
And even convincing people like
I've been convinced that this is a very good move on her part. I think sending the right people from New Zealand, as she is suggesting, I think could make a huge difference.
Well, the fact is, Matt, that yelling at them has not really produced anything in the last 20 years, has it?
It always comes better from friends and neighbours.
Yeah.
And New Zealand has always claimed the fact that we have a high Polynesian population in New Zealand is an advantage for us in terms of when we deal with Fiji.
I like the way, particularly too, she handled the business of entrenchment. Now to move on to the entrenchment of the Maori seats. She said she finds it interesting that after all of these years, Labour, now they're in opposition, suddenly come up with an entrenchment term.
And a review in the seabed and foreshores and taking a constructive approach.
You see, is the confidence and supply agreement going to come unstuck on the foreshore and seabed, Matt?
No, because what they really do is a review. See, everyone is underestimated the political smarts of those Māori MPs. They've been around a long time doing compromises and everything. What Nat's agreed to a review, that Labour now is buying in, whatever comes out, it will look like a win.
It is the litmus test, though, for whether they can come up with a solution that keeps the people who voted for the Māori Party happy, the National voters who rushed to National after the Ariwa speech. I mean, that's going to be real challenge.
For Labour? they're going to vote National anyway.
Still to come on the programme, more from your panel and your comments and what to look for next week in the political news. But next I'm going to be speaking to a man very much in the hot seat of dealing with international crisis at the moment, the Air New Zealand Chief Executive, Rob Fyfe. And remember, we want to hear from you, so text your thoughts and first name to 8850. Each text costs 50 cents, and you can email us for free at qna@tvnz.co.nz.